Today we are going to study about attitude. You must be wondering what attitude is. So attitude is basically a set of mind, something which is in our mind, something we think about. It is a set of our views and thoughts, the viewpoints we have about people, places, objects. It also has an evaluative feature, which means we can evaluate an attitude. It can be either positive or negative. It can also be neutral. For example, attitude towards junk food. It has to be negative. Attitude, some people have a positive attitude towards exercising and well-being. Moving on, attitude is always about some topic. So here the example of junk food, the junk food becomes an attitude object. Whichever topic we have that attitude about, it can be positive or negative, that becomes our attitude object. Let us now talk about the components of attitude. Basically, there are three components of attitude, that is A, B, C component. A is for effective, which means if we have an attitude towards something, like we say mobile phones, we are very emotional towards it. B is our behavior towards it. So if I have a negative attitude towards mobile phone, so you will see that I am not using it, or I particularly deny the use of mobile phones. It is also, behavior refers to the tendency to act. And C is for cognitive, which is related to our thoughts. So the three components of attitude are A, B, C, that is affective, the emotional component, behavioral, that is the tendency to act. It is not necessary to act, but there is a strong tendency to act. And C is cognitive, which means the thoughts are also involved. So now we are going to talk about the features of attitude. Basically, there are four features of attitude. An attitude has to be these four things. First is, an attitude must have a valence. Valence means either the attitude is positive or the attitude is negative. So for example, about a healthy lifestyle, I am very positive. So here, positivity is the valence of my attitude. Then comes extremeness. Extremeness means how positive or how negative that attitude is. So if I am very crazy about being healthy, I go to the gym, I go to the fitness classes, I exercise a lot, I eat healthy food, then my attitude is extremely positive. So even in the positive category, we can divide it as positive or very positive, good or very good. The third thing which we have is simplicity or complexity. So our attitude, is it simple or is it complex? So in a case, if there is this person A, I have an attitude about him, it is a very simple attitude. So it doesn't have any layers. But complexity there has, let's talk about well-being. Different people have different ideas, different thinking, different attitude about well-being. So it is a very complex attitude because it has a lot of categories. It is a broader dimension. It has various attitude inside it. And the last one we'll say is centrality. Let us take the example of Gandhiji. Non-violent. He was a very non-violent person. So for him, this attitude was the central attitude of his life. Everything that he did was revolving around centrality, was revolving around this attitude. Therefore, the four features we talk about attitude are: number one,